Šīs ir pieci.
Ceturtdien, 2. jūlijas, un ciemos pie mums 5. rītos ir kārtējais prominentais džēza viesis. Erika Trufā kvartets šobrīd skan man fonā ar El Tiempo de la Revolucion, un slavenais trumpetists Erika Trufā šovakar uzstāsies kongresnamā pulksten 19. Projekta Boog and Friends ietvaros kopā ar turku saksofonistu Ilhanu Ersahinu, amerikāņu producentu Joaquinu Jo Klasēlu, kā arī norvēģu basistu Marius Rexie un bundzinieku Andreasu B. Šāds speciāls projekts. 5 cilvēku sastāvā šovakar pulksten 19. Sastopams Rīgas kongresa namā. Hello, Eric.
Hello.
It's really nice to have you here, an honor to have you here in our studio. So this is not your first time in Riga. You're coming here.
I played last year.
Okay.
With Artis, a drum from Riga, and cello, Siegfried on cello.
Was that your first time?
And now I came also two times before, yeah.
So how you like Latvia? How you like our audience?
It's perfect. I love Riga. There are a lot really nice place and a lot of good bar, and the girls are incredible.
Okay. Whenever we have jazz musicians here in the studio, I always start the interview with the question, what is jazz? So what does the word jazz mean to you, Eric?
Well, jazz is music. It's a music from the past and from now. So it's a lot of music, you know. The rock and roll, the blues, the soul music come from jazz. So it was a really popular music, and now it's more special music, but it's still popular for me, yeah.
Louis Armstrong, Miles Davis, Chad Baker, some of the most important names in jazz are trumpet players. So have you ever wondered why?
I don't understand what is a wonder why. My English is not perfect.
That's okay, but have you ever thought why? Why is this situation like this?
No, what I can say that for Chad Baker and Louis Armstrong, they were really famous because they sing really good, and the singing is really popular. And Miles, he changed the music like Picasso changed the painting. That's a response.
But not the trumpet. Trumpet is not the thing that connects.
But for Miles, yeah, it was the trumpet, but it really changed the form. I'm a little bit popular because I change a little bit the form. I play jazz, but in a rock style. I play with singer. If I played really whole jazz, straight jazz, I would not be known like this.
Okay, we have to translate some of the things you said. Ko mums Eriks ir pateicis līdz šim?
Eriks stāstīja, ka jazz pirmkārt ir mūzika. Džess ir lieta, kas savieno pagātni un tagadni. Un runājot par ietekmīgākajiem mūziķiem, ietekmīgākajiem trompetistiem vēsturē, viņš teica, ka Chet Bakers un Louis Armstrong bija ļoti populāri, jo viņi dziedāja. Savukārt Miles Davis bija cilvēks, kurš tāpat kā
Picasso
vienkārši mainīja vispār džezu kā tādu. Ar savu spēles manieru, īsumā.
Tell us about what was the main reason you became interested in trumpet playing in the first place?
Because my father played trumpet, played sax, and he pushed me to play trumpet, for this.
He didn't want you to play saxophone?
No. Because he has a band and he wanted
needed someone to play there. That's all right. As you already said, it seems to me one of your main goals is to combine, I would call it, intelligent pop music with jazz. And for example, your album Arkhangelsk, in my opinion, is one of the best examples I know where academic genre meets something not so academic. So do you see the same way I do? Is that your goal, to combine those two worlds?
How I combine, see?
Is that the goal for you?
Yeah, the first thing, it's my work is a band work.
Okay.
And we are all really interested how interest is really large in music. And for example, I listen more rock and pop music than jazz music at home.
Okay.
That's the response.
What's your favorite record right now? What are you listening to? Like, for example, if you said you're listening to pop and rock.
You know, I'm a whole guy from the 17, so I listen a lot of old stuff.
Okay.
So I listen a lot of Radiohead.
Okay.
For example, but also 2 days ago I listened to old Rolling Stone in my car.
Okay. Okay. Isn't it hard to work with musicians with non-academic background? For example, one of your last records was a collaboration with electronic producer Murkoff.
Yeah.
And maybe you can tell us, well, how did it came about? And yeah, isn't it hard for you to
No. What is hard for me would be to play just straight jazz music. But for me, it's natural to play with electronic music, to play with rock music.
Vai tu ko sēt?
Jā, Eriks stāstīja, kā viņš sāka spēlēt trompeti, jo viņa tēvs bija saksofonists un viņam grupā laikam vajadzēja trompetistu. Un tā arī Eriks sāka spēlēt un tad Toms jautāja par akadēmiskās mūzikas savienojumu ar popmūziku, vai tas ir mērķis un Eriks teica, ka viņa grupai patīk eksperimentēt.
Un viņš teica, ka viņam būtu grūti būt tikai klasiskā džēza mūziķi, bet šajos te dažādās modernās savienojumos ir daudz vieglāk darboties.
On how many projects you are working right now? And with how many projects you are touring right now? Do you have a count?
No. Now I just finished a new album.
Okay.
With my quartet and African singer. And she's called Rokia Traoré.
Okay.
And a rapper on one tune is called Oxmo Puccino.
Okay.
I just finished.
But you're as I know you're working with Artis Orups, the Latvian drummer as well. Are you playing?
I played
concert?
With Artis two weeks ago.
Okay.
But it was not my project. It was what we did in Riga last time with my friend Siegfried. Yeah, I had many projects with other people. For example, next week I played in Vienna. It's a big big festival in France with French guy Yvinek and Arto. It will be electronic music and video.
Okay, and how did it came? How do you came up with the idea to work with Artis Orups?
No, you know, I develop a lot of idea from my music, but when the people invite me, I take them idea. For example, with Bugge, he composed the music and he give us the music.
So tonight's show. Can you describe what to expect?
Yes. The music we made with Bugge is a kind of electro jazz with a DJ, and we meet each other 15 years ago because we made the same music, the same kind of music.
Mm-hmm.
He was in Norway and I was in France, and yes, now we play the tune from Bugge Wesseltoft and one tune from me.
Do you have something you still want to achieve musically?
When you
wake up in the morning, is there still something you want to do musically, something you have never done?
Yes. You know, physically, when I wake up in the morning, I need to practice the trumpet. It because of practicing of trumpet, you use the breath,
okay,
and it's like a kind of yoga. It puts me good.
Oh, but all said,
it's strange, but it's. Like
No rītiem pamostoties Erikam patīk vingrināties trompetes pūšanā, jo tas liek atmosties visai iekšējai sistēmai un plaušām.
Jā, un iepriekš mēs runājam par projektiem, kuros Eriks darbojas. Viņš spēlē, viņam patīk spēlēt ar dažādiem māksliniekiem un, piemēram, kopā ar latviešu bundzinieku Artu Orupu. Viņam ir savēdis kāds cits projekts, kur viņi ik pa laikam uzstājās pēdējais pirms divām nedēļām Bīnē. Un pirms gada un pirms diviem gadiem Rīgā un arī šovakar būs
īpašs projekts.
Īpašs jā. Projekts kopā ar Norvēģu tausmīgas manais Bugi Veselhof, kas arī ir, viņam, var sakot, viņam patīk dažādi sound projekti, ne tikai savus, savus darbus.
And we have still, we have few questions from our listeners to you. For example, what are you reading at the moment? Is there something you're reading?
Yes, yes, I read police book, policier, you know, you understand?
Yeah.
From Laurent Guillaume, it's a French writer, and also I read Marguerite Yourcenar, Oriental News.
Okay.
I always try to read a really popular book, really easy for the plane, and something more high, like Proust or Yourcenar. I'm a really big fan of book.
Okay. Do you have any musical authorities at the moment?
What means authorities?
Yeah, all the sentence. That's a correct thing. But
idols.
Like musical. Idols. Someone you are looking up to.
Yes, for sure. I have. Yes, I have my biggest idol is for sure Miles Davis and Stravinsky.
Still.
Yeah.
Okay. And what is the best album ever recorded?
Yeah, there is many album in many kind of music. You have to choose the style of the music, rock, or jazz.
Let's say jazz.
For me,
is it still Miles Davis?
Yeah,
something from him.
Yeah, for sure, for sure. For me, it's kind of blue from Miles Davis. Yeah.
All right, we're gonna play a track "Let Me Go" from In Between album right now, and I have to say really thank you for coming in this early to do this interview today.
Yes, thank you.
And have a nice day in Riga. It's gonna be sunny and warm day.
Yes,
and,
yes, it's wonderful.
And see you tonight at 7 o'clock in the evening.
Yes.
In Congress Noms. Eriks Trufā, franču trompetists, šorīt ciemos pie mums. Piec rīt studijā, Ulda ir vēl fiksi pēdējie tulkojumi par to, ko mēs dzirdējām pēdējā intervijas noslēgumā.
Jā, klausītāja jautājums, ko Eriks šobrīd lasa. Es, diemžēl, neiztulkoju grāmatu nosaukumus, bet to varēs dzirdēt video atkārtojumā. Viņš lasa kādu franču autoru darbu. Un jautājums par labāko albumu vienmēr, protams, ir diskusija vai roks vai džess, un nu, mēģinot vienoties par labāko džēza albumu visu laiku, Eriks saka, ka tas ir Miles Davis, Kind of Blue.
Un muzikāli alka Erikam ir Miles Davis un Stravinskis.
Skaidrs. 9:54 minūtes. Again, thank you very much. Merci beaucoup for coming to our studio, and let's hear another track from you. Tātad Eriks Trufā, In Between albums un skaņdarbs Let Me Go. Piedalosies 5 LV.